Hi friends, welcome to the new series Angular Interview Concepts with Explanation. In this series, I'm explaining some of the concepts those are most focused on Angular interviews. If you just prepare for your Angular interview like a question and answer format, it won't help you a lot. If the same question is asked differently, you may struggle. Instead, if you understand the core concept behind that, you will not forget forever and you can easily answer. That is what I'm trying to explain with some examples. Let's start. As part of Angular Hero to Superhero series, I have explained how we can create and use Observable and Promise for handling asynchronous functionalities. If you have not seen that video yet, please see that before this video. I have provided the link in the description. In Angular interviews, you can expect at least one question related to Observable and Promise. One of the most important questions is, what is the difference between Observable and Promise? That is what I am going to explain in this video. For that, I have created an Angular application in which I have three buttons and each button is calling a function. In the TypeScript component, right now all three functions are empty. Okay, the first difference is Observable is having three callbacks, success, error and complete. But Promise is having only two callbacks, success and error. I have already explained this in my previous video about Observable and Promise. So let me move to the next one. Observables are lazy and Promises are not lazy. In other words, we can say Promises are eager. What does that mean? Promises execute immediately once after it is created, but observables will not execute until we subscribe to them. Let's see this now. Let me declare two variables, one for observable and another one for promise. And inside the create function, let me create one observable and one promise. Let me also put one console.log inside so that we can understand. Also, let me emit the data in both. Now, if I click create button, we can see only the console log from promise. So it is clear observable is not yet executed, but promise is executed when it is created. So now inside execute function, let me subscribe to observable and use the then callback in promise and print the values inside. Now when I click create, we can see promise alone is created. And when I click execute, we can see now observable is created and then emitted. We can see promise is also emitted. So I believe you understood now why we are saying observable is lazy and promise is eager. Next difference is observable emits multiple values over a period of time, but promise emits only one value. Let me explain. Inside create function, instead of emitting one value, let me emit three values in both observable and in promise. Now if I create and execute, we can see observable has emitted all three values, but promise has emitted only the first value. To explain it more clearly, let me use set interval to emit data over a period of time. Now we can see promise is emitted only one time, but observable is keep on emitting data. So I believe you understood this difference too. Next difference is observable is cancelable, but promise is not cancelable. That means in observable, we can use a subscription and we can cancel the subscription. Let me show that. I'm creating a new variable for subscription. And in execute function, let me assign the subscription to this. And in cancel method, I can unsubscribe like this. Now in create function, let me change the set interval to set timeout so that it will execute only one time. And also let me increase the timer to 5 seconds. So after I create and execute, we can see we got the data after 5 seconds. If I create it and click the execute after 5 seconds, we can see we received the data from promise, but the data from observable will reach us only after 5 seconds. That is because when I click create, the code inside promise will be executed, and so the counter for promise will be started immediately. But the counter for observable will be started only when I click the execute button. That means only after I subscribe, because it is lazy. Okay, coming back to the subscription. Now I am going to click the create button. After that, I am going to click the execute button immediately so that both the counter will start. And after a second, I am going to click the cancel button. That means I am going to cancel the observable. Let's see. Now we can see we are not receiving data from observable because we have cancelled the subscription. But in promise, we don't have such mechanism. To explain it clearly, let me change the set timeout back to set interval. And also let me reduce the timer to 1 second so that let the data emit continuously. Now when I create and execute, we can see observable is keep on emitting data. When I click cancel, it will stop emitting. So I believe you understood observable is cancelable, but promise is not. Next difference is promises are always asynchronous, but observable can be synchronous or asynchronous. To explain that, in create function, let me comment these codes and emit only one value in both. And let me also immediately execute the observable and promise once after it is created in the same function. Now we can see promise is present before observable. But as promise is always synchronous, this code execution will go into even loop. And so observable is executed as it is synchronous here, and then promise is executed. So we can see observable first and then promise. But we can make observable asynchronous by wrapping this inside a set timeout function like this. Now as both are asynchronous now, we can see promise is emitted first and then observable. So I believe it is clear to you we can make observable both synchronous and asynchronous, but promise will be always asynchronous. Apart from that, observable also supports few RXJS operators like filter, reduce, retry, etc. But promise don't support these operators. To see how we can use retry, please see my previous video on HTTP interceptors. These are some of the differences between observable and promise. Hope you understood. Please subscribe to my channel and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.